Welcome to the Ultimate Sports Podcast. Today is Friday, April 12, 2019. Today I'm going to recap yesterday's Stanley Cup playoff games, look ahead to tonight's games, go over last night's baseball games, look ahead to tonight's games, look ahead to tomorrow's NBA playoff games a little bit. Not going to give away my picks for game one, only because I'm going to do my playoff preview podcast coming up. Also, I'm going to go over some news with college basketball and NBA, and also a contract extension given out in baseball and my best bet of the day. All right, let's start with the Stanley Cup playoffs. Only three games last night on the slate. Some interesting results, others were to be expected. First up, Maple Leafs over the Bruins 4-1 in game one. As Toronto takes a 1-0 series lead, that's a great win for them. Going out there to Boston and stealing game one. After, by the way, Patrice Bergeron's got the first goal of the game, only goal for Boston on the power play. 1-0 Bruins. Mitch Marner scores to tie it up at 1-1. Mitch Marner again in the second period to put the Leafs up 2-1. William Nylander, 3-0 Leafs. Third period, John Tavares, 4-0 Leafs, and that was your final. Marner had two goals. He was their number one star. Number two star of the game with 37 saves on 38 shots. Frederick Anderson, number three star of the game with the goal. Patrice Bergeron. Capitals over the Hurricanes, 4-2. Caps take a 1-0 series lead. Caps were dominant in the first period. Backstrom scores, 1-0 Caps. Backstrom again on the power play, 2-0 Caps. Alex Ovechkin on the power play, 3-0 Caps. Scoreless second period, third period. Here comes Carolina. Andrei Svechnikov makes it 3-1. Svechnikov again makes it 3-2. Lars Eller into the empty net. 4-2 Caps was your final. Give Carolina credit for making this a game and making Columbus work a little harder in the third period. Flames over the Abs, 4-0. Calgary takes a 1-0 series lead. An impressive win for Calgary. No goals in the first period, but in the second period, the first goal of the game scored by Andrew Magnapapi to make it a 1-0 Flames lead. Matthew Tkachuk on the power play, 2-0 Flames. Mikael Backlund on the power play to begin the third period, 3-0 Flames, and Tkachuk again late in the third period to make it 4-0 Flames. So number one star of the game at 26 saves on 26 shots, Mike Smith. Number two star of the game at two goals, Matthew Tkachuk. And the number three star of the game with the goal, Andrew Magnapani. Four games on the slate tonight, 7 o'clock on CNBC of the Blue Jackets at the Lightning. Columbus up 1-0 in the series. This is a huge must win for Tampa. I think they're going to get it done. Wouldn't be shocked if this is a blowout, but I think it's a close game. So give me 4-1. I just think that they're going to come out and play really hard. And Andrei Vasilevskiy's going to have a monster game. 7:30 NBCSN, the Penguins at the Islanders. I'm going to take Penguins here to tie it up at 1-1. The Blues at the Jets, 9:30 CNBC. I'm going to take Winnipeg here to tie this series up at 1-1. And then 10:30 NBCSN, the Golden Knights at the Sharks. I'm going to take the Golden Knights to tie up this series at 1-1. So I'm going to roll with two home teams and two road teams, all to even up their respective series is at 1. And I'm not going to have a podcast for Saturday or Sunday. So the rest of the schedule for the weekend, Hurricanes at the Caps, Stars at the Preds, Bruins host the Maple Leafs, and then Abs at the Flames. And then Sunday, 12 o'clock NBC, Islanders, Penguins, 7 o'clock NBCSN, Lightning, Blue Jackets, 7:30 CNBC, Jets, Blues, and 10 o'clock NBCSN, the Sharks of the Golden Knights. And by the way, the start times and the channels for the Saturday games, the Capitals hosting the Hurricanes at 3 o'clock NBC. That's probably going to be John Forslund and Pierre Maguire. Stars, Predators, 6 o'clock CNBC, 8 o'clock on the big NBC, Maple Leafs, Bruins, and then 10:30 NBCSN, the Avalanche at the Flames. Now I'm going to go over the baseball results from yesterday. Not a lot of games yesterday. A lot of teams were traveling. Reds over the Marlins, 5-0. Cincinnati's 4-8. Miami's 3-10. Robert Stevenson gets the win. He's 1-0. Pablo Lopez, the loss. He's 1-2. Athletics over the Orioles, 8-5. A's are 9-8. Baltimore's 5-8. Aaron Brooks gets the win. He's 2-1. Dylan Bundy, the loss. He's 0-1. Blake Treinen gets his fourth save of the year. Indians over the Tigers, 4-0. Cleveland's 8-4. Detroit's 8-5. Shane Bieber gets the win. He's 1-0. And Stephen Trumbull, the loss. He's 0-2. Cardinals over the Dodgers, 11-7. Cards 8-5. Dodgers 8-6. Giovanni Gallegos to win. He's 1-0. And Pedro Baez, the loss. He's 0-1. Mariners over the Royals, 7-6 in 10 innings. Seattle 13-2. KC's 2-10. The winning pitcher from Seattle is Brandon Brennan, 1-0. George Sparkman, the loss, he's 0-1. And getting the save yesterday for the Mariners was Connor Sadzik. Red Sox over the Blue Jays, 7-6. Huge win for Boston, they're 4-9. Toronto's 4-9. The winning pitcher in this game, Marcus Walden. The losing pitcher, Ken Giles. And by the way, this was a walk-off hit by Rafael Devers to give Boston a big win. Mets over the Braves, 6-3. Mets are 8-4, Atlanta's 7-5. Steven Matz gets the win. Kevin Gausman, the loss. Edwin Diaz, the save. Cubs over the Pirates, 2-0. Cubs are 4-8. Pittsburgh, 6-5. There's a rain delay in this game. Padres over the Diamondbacks, 7-6. Pods are 9-5. D-backs are 6-7. Craig Stammen, the win. He's 1-0. Archie Bradley, the loss. He's 0-1. And getting the save for the Padres, Trey Wingenter. Giants over the Rockies, 1-0. The lone run of this game was on a home run by Kevin Pillar. The Giants are 5-9. Colorado's 3-10. Jeff Samardzija, the win. He's 1-0. John Gray, the loss. He's 0-3. Will Smith gets his fourth save of the year. Tonight's games, well, there's one actually today. The Angels at the Cubs at 2:20. Tyler Skaggs against Cole Hamels. Skaggs 1-1 with a 2.45. Hamels 1-0 with a 5.73. 7 o'clock, White Sox Yankees. Lucas Giolito against Jay Happ. Giolito 1-1 with a 5.73. Happ 0-1 with a 6.48. Pirates Nationals. Trevor Williams against Patrick Corbin. Williams 1-0 with a 2.25. Corbin doesn't have a decision but has a 3.75 ERA. Rays, Blue Jays, Ryan Stanek and Trent Thornton. Both pitchers are 1-0. I'm sorry, don't have any decisions. Stanek has a 1.5 and Thornton has a 1.69, so Rays go an opener. Orioles, Red Sox, David Hess and Eduardo Rodriguez. Hess 1-1 with a 2.7, Rodriguez 0-2 with a 12.38. Phillies, Marlins, Jake Arrieta and Sandy Alcantara. Arrieta 1-1 with a 2.77. Alcantara 1-0 with a 1.5. Mets Braves at 7:20. Zach Wheeler and Sean Newcomb. Wheeler 0-1 with a 10.24. Newcomb doesn't have a decision, but yeah, he has a 1.64 ERA. 8 o'clock, the Athletics at the Rangers. Mike Fiers and Drew Smyly. Fiers 2-1 with a 5.94. Smyly 0-1 with a 7.11. Tigers Twins postponed. Makeup date May 11th. 8:15 Indians Royals. Carlos Carrasco and Brad Keller. Carrasco 1-1 with the 7.71. Keller 1-1 with the 2.84. At 9:40, the Padres at the Diamondbacks. Chris Paddock and Luke Weaver. Both pitchers don't have any decisions. Paddock has a 1.04 ERA. Weaver a 6.75. 10 o'clock Brewers Dodgers. So the NLCS rematch. Corbin Burns and Julio Urias. Burns 0-1 with a 9.9. Urias doesn't have a decision but has a 3.12 ERA. Astros Mariners, that's a big one. Prove it series for Seattle. Wade Miley and Wade LeBlanc. Miley 1-1 with a 2.31. LeBlanc 2-0 with a 4.76. And 10:15, the Rockies at the Giants. Chad Bettis and Drew Pomeranz. Bettis 0-2 with an 11.88. Pomeranz 0-1 with a 4. Some news I want to get to. Ozzie Albies signs a 7-year, $35 million contract extension. I think that's a good contract for Albies. There's some backlash on it on social media about it, which I don't understand. But Albies was an all-star a year ago, if I'm not mistaken, and he's somebody that has untapped potential. I think that he's going to be a top 10 with a chance to be a top 5 second baseman in the game for years to come. He has a ton of power. He plays with a lot of energy. He's fast. He's a good defender. So the Braves are locking up their young core fast. First Acuna and now Albies. Maybe if Dansby Swanson improves a little bit, maybe he gets paid. Freddie Freeman got paid a while ago. So a nice contract for Albies. Some breaking NBA news. OG Anunoby of the Raptors out 2+ weeks. Raptors forward had an emergency appendectomy and is expected to miss at least 2 weeks. That is breaking news before the Raptors go on their playoff run. And that's a big loss for them. He has made strides for them coming off the bench and providing some good play. I think they can get away with it for at least the first round against the Bucks are playing the Pistons. That'd be weird if they were playing the Pistons, because Dwayne Casey against his former team would have been a fun storyline. The Magic, who I think are the worst of the 8 playoff teams in the East. So I think they'll get away with it. Does this change my prediction of the series? No, but it's certainly a story worth noting. 2 more NBA coaching changes happened yesterday. The Memphis Grizzlies fired J.B. Bickerstaff after a season which I thought this team overachieved this year. 33 wins. I did not think Memphis would win 33 games, especially after the trading of Marc Gasol. But again, these Western Conference coaches that overachieve and firing their head coaches. Like, what the heck? I mean, is there somebody better than Bickerstaff out there? Bickerstaff, I don't think he's that great of a coach, but I thought he got that group to overachieve this year. I had Memphis finishing 27-55, so by my standards, they overachieved. And it's just sad that coach loses his job, because what the Grizzlies expect? To make the playoffs? You're supposed to be bad anyway. A lot of people thought you were going to trade Mike Conley and Marc Gasol. You ended up trading one. The other one's probably going to get traded in the summer. And then they made some front office changes as well, with Chris Wallace and John Hollinger both being reassigned in the organization. So they're going to be hunting for a new president of basketball ops and GM as well. The other team that made the coaching change was the Cleveland Cavaliers. Larry Drew and the team part ways. Larry Drew took over for the fired Ty Lue. And the Cavs obviously were tanking this year. Larry Drew's not a good NBA coach, so they said it was mutual, but I think they fired him. And this was obviously the move to make if you're Cleveland. I don't mind this coaching change. Just hire one of the new hot assistants like Atlanta did with Lloyd Pierce, who I think did excellent this year coaching the Hawks. And maybe they could find a little something and find the next Brett Brown or the next Lloyd Pierce. And instead of big name hunting or getting a veteran guy. So should be interesting to see where Cleveland and Memphis go. If I'm them, I hire a hot assistant and start a rebuild for both of those teams. Although Memphis has kind of jump-started with the trading of Gasol, and then they had the top 4 pick last year and picked Jaren Jackson Jr., who is a good rookie for them. And then Cleveland obviously began their rebuild after LeBron James left. They pick Colin Sexton in the draft with the pick that they got from Boston via Brooklyn with the trade of Kyrie Irving, which the Celtics got that pick in the Garnett Pierce deal from Brooklyn. So they have Sexton at least, and CeeDee Osmond's a nice player for Cleveland too. So you can make a case the Cavaliers are quote-unquote further along in their rebuild in Memphis, but you could argue that the Grizzlies have the better player with those three and Jaren Jackson Jr. And the other thing for Cleveland is that they have more assets to trade. That's why I'm arguing that Cleveland's further along, because Kevin Love's going to be traded this summer, I think. But I don't know who will acquire him. I think it's going to be somebody that loses out on free agents, like the Brooklyn Nets or somebody like that. Maybe New York Knicks if they lose out on Zion, or not that Zion's a free agent, he's obviously in the draft, but if they miss the lottery and they miss out on Anthony Davis and Boogie Cousins, they could trade for Kevin Love. That could be like a consolation, sort of. Maybe the Clippers can go after Kevin Love. They have assets to trade. So, should be an interesting offseason for both the Grizzlies and the Cavaliers. And now, my best bet of the day, brought to you by FanDuel. I am leaning strongly towards a couple of the Stanley Cup playoff games, and obviously baseball as well. I'm going to go with the Lightning. I'm going to go with the Yankees. The Red Sox, the Athletics, the Indians, and I don't feel super about picking the Astros, but I'm going to do it anyway. That's six teams, about 13 and a third the one odds, wagering $1, payout of $14.34. That's it for today. I'll be back on Monday recapping all the NBA and Stanley Cup playoff games. I'll have mock drafts for both the NBA and the NHL, power rankings for baseball, players of the week, and a lot more, and obviously my best bet too. Hope you guys have a great weekend, everybody.